Hey guys, so today I wanted to go back and look at a concept car again, this time the 1994 Dodge Venom. I always rotate the different types of videos I make, and it's been over a month since I made the last concept car video, which was on the 2008 Dodge Avenger Stormtrooper concept. If you're new to the channel, I do have a few different series of concept cars. There's one where I go over 4 to 5 concepts in one video, one where I compare the concept car to its production version, and ones like today where I go very in depth on just one concept and give you more information that I wouldn't have time for in those other series. So make sure to check out my concept car playlist if you do want to see more content like this. But today, let's have a look at the Dodge Venom, a car that was highly popular with car enthusiasts for many years after its release. I've tried to do my best with the photos available, but there weren't a whole lot out there. The Dodge Venom concept first made its world debut on January 3rd, 1994 at the Chicago Auto Show. This sports car was a two-door coupe with a front engine and rear-wheel drive layout. You may not be able to tell just from looking at it, but the Venom was built on a modified version of the Chrysler PL platform that was used for the Dodge Neon. The wheelbase was extended and it had a rear-wheel drive layout instead of front-wheel drive. One of the reasons Dodge wanted to build a Venom was to showcase their cab-forward design on a two-seater car, and we'll get more into that later. Overall, the car had a very unique body, and alongside that modified Neon chassis and a modified Intrepid engine, it got many Dodge fans excited because clearly the company was starting to seriously think about bringing a muscle car back to the Dodge or Mopar lineup. As for the cost, the base model was projected to be around $9,000, with a fully loaded version topping out at $13,000. I've added the inflation numbers on screen for what they would cost today, and those prices really do make it a bargain based on what else you can get. You can also see the Venom slogan on screen, reading, "Yesterday's power, today's sophistication." As for the design of the Venom, there are many mixed opinions about whether or not it looks good. I've seen many comments, ranging from people thinking that it looks great, to others thinking that it looks disgusting. I personally think the design is pretty decent, and it suits the time frame, early to mid-90s. Just take a look at a Viper from the same year. And this design was somewhat based off of the Dodge Viper, as you can see the two do look very similar. The concept featured a Venom yellow-green pearl paint job, along with a flat black hood. As I mentioned, the cab forward design was showcased here, and the Venom was built on a highly modified Neon platform where the wheelbase was stretched by 2 inches, from 104 to 106 inches overall. As for some other dimensions, the overall length is 182.6 inches, the width is 74.9 inches, and the height is 51.5 inches. The cab forward design was used by Chrysler Corporation starting in 1992, with the first model of the Dodge Intrepid sedan. The passenger cabin gets pushed forward so the front doors sit right at the edge of the wheel wells, and the windshield is extended forward over the engine. The rear wheels are shifted back towards the far corners of the vehicle as well. By moving the wheels farther towards the edge of the car, this cab forward design makes for a larger and more spacious interior than other vehicles that are similar in size. Everything ahead of the cabin, including the engine, is packed into a much smaller space, and that leaves a lot more room for the rest of the car and the interior. As for the rest of the car, it was built with steel and had an aluminum structure and a cantilever roofline that still looks pretty good today. Some parts were taken from various other Chrysler vehicles, like a handlebar grille inspired by the Dodge Coronet, side scoops from the Viper, and a rear end molded after the Challenger and Barracuda. Unfortunately, there's almost nothing to show on screen for the Venom interior, since there were almost no pictures or videos of it anywhere online. The interior looks quite similar to other Chrysler products at the time, and it doesn't look like too much has changed for the Venom. The steering wheel, shifter, and handbrake are leather wrapped, featuring yellow accents on the gray base color. The rest of the interior is also made up of a grayish black color. The front bucket seats do look comfortable, upholstered in leather, and they do include a lot of shoulder support, and there's the matching yellow accent on the seat backs as well. The performance of the Venom was quite good for a mid-90s vehicle. It featured a 3.5-liter overhead cam 24-valve V6, and that got paired with a 6-speed manual transmission. The engine was based on the Intrepid production version, but it did pack more power. It was tuned to produce between 245 to 260 horsepower and 221 pound-feet of torque. It's not a crazy amount of power, but because the Venom only weighed in at 2,700 pounds, it still had a very respectable 0-60 time of 5.2 seconds and a top speed of 145 miles per hour. The engine block was made of cast iron, featuring some carbon fiber and Kevlar Aramid fiber components as well. The suspension was totally independent, with double wishbones, coil springs, and gas shocks. A staggered rim and tire setup was used here, and the sizes were massive for the time, with 245/45/19 tires in the front on 19-inch wheels, and 20-inch wheels with 245/45/20 tires in the rear. Beneath the wheels were disc brakes with 13-inch rotors and electronic ABS. Also, because the wheels were pushed out towards the corners, the handling agility increased as well. Finally, a performance exhaust with quad tips added some nice sound to the Venom. Unfortunately, despite tons of attention from car enthusiasts, the Viper never did make it to production. The Venom was actually featured at different auto shows in the international circuit for years, and it was constantly a hit. Most concepts only get attention for a few weeks before things die down, but this wasn't the case for the Venom. Nonetheless, it did eventually fall out of the spotlight, and Chrysler never really provided a reason for the lack of a production version, and it quietly died. It would spend over 2 years on display at the Walter P. Chrysler Museum. In my mind, the Venom did carry some significance, even if it never did make it to production. Chrysler was able to prove that they could take blander vehicles, like the production Neon and Intrepid, and really spice them up. They proved they could make a rear-wheel drive muscle car on a Neon chassis, and they proved they were serious enough about adding more performance in their lineup going forward. It was one of their first attempts at making a modern muscle car, and Chrysler would keep trying different concepts until the Dodge Challenger SRT8 finally arrived in 2008. I do think that this was a lost opportunity, however. It was a futuristic, affordable, efficient, and powerful driving machine that took things back to the basics, and I think that it would have been a real hit marketed as some sort of cheaper Viper in the Dodge lineup, for those that can afford that beast. It wouldn't have really threatened the Viper all that much, which was a lot better performance-wise, with 0-60 times in the low 4-second range, and came with well over 400 horsepower. If the Venom production version was anything like the concept, I think it would have been a smashing success. Another reason why the Venom was significant is that it did allow Chrysler to showcase their cab-forward design, as we talked about. And from 1993 to 2004, they would use this design on many of their other production vehicles, like the Chrysler LH platform with the Dodge Intrepid, Chrysler Concorde, and others, the JA platform with the Chrysler Cirrus and Dodge Stratus, and the PL platform with the Neon. So that's the end of this video, guys. What did you think of the Venom? I really do think that it was a lost opportunity, and I wonder what could have been if it had made it to the production version. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and make sure to like and subscribe for more Mopar content. And let me know if you do want to see other concept car videos like this one. I'll see you in the next video. Man.